Hello.
Ha! Did I scare you? I hope I did. No, my microphone wasn't cut out there. No, your volume wasn't too low. I just wanted to spook you. Normally, I ask you to subscribe to me at the start of my videos. Not today. Subscribe to everyone else who took part in this video as they deserve it. All their links are in the description. But if you want to subscribe to me, that's fine. But yeah, let's start. Now, it always fascinates me to see how other people build in Minecraft. Whether they use a resource pack, whether they use shaders, what blocks they use, what style they're building. I think you get what I'm saying. So I thought it'd be fun today to build a basic house and then send it to 5 of my YouTube friends and get them to transform it. Now, I'm also going to transform it to show you how I would transform the house, but I'm really interested to see how others transform the house. First, however, we need to build a house and we're gonna make it basic. Oh boy, are we gonna make it basic. So we're not just giving them just a house, we're giving them an entire plot. It's 40 by 40 blocks, as you can see here. There's a bridge over the water. We've got a very basic Minecraft house made out of like wood and a little bit of stone on top. Nothing too crazy. We added some greenery on the outside and we added some basic interior inside. Let me show you in a bit more detail. So as you can see, not very big plot whatsoever. We've got a really basic bridge, some trees, some bone milled ground, a very basic river in the middle, and the house itself is nothing too special. No detailing really, it's just, you know, oak and stone. Inside, however, we do have some interior. We've got an enchanting room, we've got a bedroom with some chests, we've got like a little armor stand, furnace area, chest area, everything you kind of need in like, you know, a basic Minecraft starter home. Now, I've said that people can use World Edit, any tools they want, but it's got to be vanilla Minecraft. However, you are allowed to use a resource pack if you so wish. Before we have a look at what everyone's done, let's have a look at what I did to this thing. Now, I said to everyone, they can change anything in the plot as long as the basic layout is there. So that is exactly what I did. I started by raising this thing up and I actually built this way before I've looked at anybody else's because I didn't want to take any influence from any of them. Kind of like they would have no influence whatsoever. They're just going to see the basic plot and change it into their own style. And you can see here, I kept the layout very similar in this house. So I did make the roof different, added in some greenery, changed it to spruce as well, and also just detailed it a bit more on the outside. On the inside, I added in some extra special interior. I double layered the walls so it's nice and blue in there. And finally, added in a bit of greenery, some bushes, and another tree on the outside. And here you have it. I also changed all the trees to be like a custom trees that I've made here. This cliffside, I'm pretty happy with. We actually changed the water as well, so it looks really nice under here now. Changed the bridge as well. Not my finest bridge, but I don't think it's too bad. We changed this tree out here to be a spruce tree as well. But I kind of got inspired by Good Times with Scar with like the roof here as he has in his village in Hermitcraft. We added in a chimney as well. I think it's looking really nice from all sides now. Lots of decoration. We also added this little sort of raised up porch area as well. So let's head inside. You can see we got the fireplace here cooking away. I changed this to sort of like nice kitchen area. We still got the crafting table, furnace, blast furnace, smokers. We've got a lot more storage, but they're all barrels this time. And they're just sort of set out a bit more neatly. Over here, we got our ender chest, which I kind of like covered up a little bit. We've got our bedroom and an armor stand, nice little lamp and some more storage by the bed. We can actually head upstairs now, as yes, that's right, I did on another floor. We got an enchanting room here where, yes, level 30 enchantment is possible. Sharpness 3, gross. And then we just had a bit more storage up here as well, so I made it look kind of like cramped, like an attic. Really happy with it. But this is only what I've done, and I'm so excited to see what everyone else has done, as everyone I've asked, I think, are really, really good builders. Let's start out by checking what Scott did, aka Dang. That's a long name. So here we go. Oh, wow, this is looking awesome. Look at this. So let's start over here, where we've got a lovely looking tree, which is kind of raised up with this lovely little pond area here. That looks really nice. I like that a lot. We've got some birch trees around. He's changed the pathway here. I like this style with the furnaces. I think that goes really well. We've got a new bridge heading over with some lanterns as well. The house is a very similar shape, which is awesome. He's kind of like got very similar sort of roof style to me. And he's also added in a porch. Some rocks and stuff in the water and the sand in the water as well, I should mention. But he's gone for a very cyan style, which I like. And the basalt as well, I think looks really good there. Inside, we've got a nice little doormat and ooh, an upstairs area. But first, let's have a look around here. We got a chest room with some crafting tables, furnaces, everything you need. Nice little enchanting area as well. A lovely staircase leading up to the top floor where we got a bedroom with a lampshade and some beds. I love what he's done with it. I think it looks awesome. I like the new window up here as well. And the layout is very similar and it's looking really good. Very much Scott and his style, which is what I love about this. It's just interesting to see how everyone's changed it in a different style. Very nice. Oh, I didn't even notice that there's a waterfall here as well before. That looks awesome. Let's move on to number two, which is Fwip. Now, Fwip has his own resource pack that he uses, so we're going to be using that. Let's have a look what he's done. Oh my gosh, it's been raised up like mad. Whoa, what the heck? Oh, this resource pack might have these connected textures. That's cool. That looks awesome around the side. Okay, wow, he's gone. Oh my gosh, look at this. This is insane. So we've got a lovely river here with some salmon swimming in it and stuff. And we've got like, wow, this looks awesome under here. I love this. And the little, what? What are these? These look so cool. The sea pickle on top of the glass? Okay, what the heck? That looks awesome. We've got very nice trees on the side here as well. This whole area's been raised up, as you can see, with some overhanging cliff. And we've got a lovely bridge leading us here as well. We'll follow this path along, which winds up to the top of where the house is. Look at this. Wow. How has he fit all this in the same space? This is mental. Okay, so this is the house here. This is looking really nice. I love the roof. We've got a little cart outside as well. Got a little waterfall down here. Got some sort of like garden like bushes out here. This looks really cool with all the dirt and the wheat field over here as well. This is insane. I love this window with the spruce trap doors like that. That looks really good. The wheelbarrow, everything. Okay, let's head inside. And you can see we got a lovely lounge here with a fireplace area. We've got some nice decoration over here. Over here, we got a nice kitchen area. This is looking really nice. A kitchen table with some plant pots and sea pickles up there. There actually is a basement as well, where we've got our chest room with like ender chests as well. Furnaces all built into the ground there. And then we've actually got an upstairs as well. Wow. Okay. So we've got a nice little table up here. It looks like a pool table. That's cool. And then we've got the bedroom over here as well. Wow. Look at this window leading out. That looks really cool. And we've got the bed. Wow, this is, oh my gosh, it goes up even further. Fwip, you've outdone yourself. Oh, on the balcony over there. It's mad. Okay, I'm taking some inspiration from Fwip in the future. This is insane. How'd you even get, oh, there's an enchanting room over here. I didn't even see this. Wow, okay. I love these spruce trees as well. I love the roof, the chimney, everything. Looking really, really cool. Good job, Fwip. Wow. It's so crazy that he's taken what I've given him and made it into this. This is nuts. This is absolutely nuts. Let's move on to number three, who is Catherine. So as you can see, Catherine has her own shaders and resource pack as well. So let's have a look at this. This is going to be pretty crazy, I think. Oh, wow. This is so cute. So let's have a look here. We've got the house with the very same shape, but we've got a little garden over here. This is looking really cute. I love this texture pack. It's so cute. And the bee as well. It's just made a baby bee. That's so cool. Wow, this is looking insane. This is so bright and colorful. The river's moved and we've actually got this little waterfall instead over here, which looks lovely. The water looks so good with these shaders. What the heck? The house itself is very much in Catherine's style. I love it. Look how pink and white it is. It's so colorful. Let's have a look inside, shall we? Welcome to my home, Catherine Elizabeth. All right, inside. Oh, wow, the chests. Everything's so colorful. We've got the diamond armor over here, plus some swords. We've got some ender chests under there as well. The furnace area, crafting tables, everything you'd need. And these are all labeled as well, so you'd have, like, you know, all your tools in there. We've got a very lovely fireplace down here. Little sofa next to it, plus a very cute enchanting area as well. I like the vines there. We've got a staircase up to the next floor. We've got a nice little closet. Wow, that looks cute. I like that a lot. That looks really cool. Oh my gosh, there's quite a lot of floors in this. We've got a balcony out front. Oh, very nice, very nice. Over here in the corner, we've got a very cute little bed setting. I love the use of the player heads, you know, like little sheep plushies and stuff. That's really cute. Up the ladder here, we have something else, the sheep shrine, okay? Right? So yeah, we've got a nice little sheep shrine up there. But yeah, looking really good. I love the hanging flower pots. That looks awesome. Very, very cool. It's so crazy that this is all the same house, basically, just being transformed in so many different ways. I love it. I'm just enjoying myself with this. So there you go. There's Catherine's looking awesome. Next up, I asked Pearlescent Moon to give it a go. So let's have a look at what Pearl has done. No shader packs, no resource packs. Oh my gosh. Wow. Okay. This is looking nuts. So the trees are all in the same positions. We got the tree here has been changed. It's sort of like pine tree, I guess. We got a pathway over here as well, leading along the river, another pine tree. The river over here looking really cute. Some seagrass in it and stuff, some kelp. The bridge actually leads upwards now, quite similar to how Fwip did it, where we got this sort of like overhanging cliff looking awesome. The house itself is looking nuts. Oh my gosh, look at this. I love the roof design and the use of like the patio and stuff. We've got a back patio. Wow. Okay. Some rocks and another tree over here. The rocks all around the house looking really good. I love the use of the coral as well. Wow. Okay. And the hanging flowers. Very nice. Let's head inside, shall we? Actually, first, we've got a lovely balcony which actually stretches around the outside of the house. Why can I hear so many mobs? I'm guessing the mobs aren't meant to be here. I'm going to put it on peaceful. If the mobs were meant to be here, Pearl, I'm sorry. But let's head inside. Okay, so we got a very nice sort of like crafting area over here. Furnaces, etc. Anvils, everything you'd need. Plus a really cool storage system. Looking awesome. The enchanting room here, really nice. I love this use of the looms as like, you know, empty bookshelves. I think that looks awesome. The bedroom over here, looking really nice. We've got the storage as well. Wow, this is crazy. And then we've got like the back door over here, which leads to another porch, which looks really cool. I love the use of the carpet on this. I've never seen that before. That looks really good. We actually have an upstairs as well. Oh, this is nice. We've got like a little potion brewing area and, you know, you never want everything you'd need. And then you can actually put the trap door down, and we've got another little section over here as well with a nice little seat head looking out. Wow, that's cool. I like that a lot. This is amazing. I love seeing what everyone else has done with this. This is nuts. And there's also a balcony out here as well. Okay, well done, Pearl. This is amazing. I love it. I love the style. I love the colors, everything. All the same layout, but just so many different houses. I'm loving this. And our final build today is actually Shubble. So let's have a look at what Shubble has done. So Shubble also uses a resource pack, as you could probably tell by the grass. And this is like a very strange resource pack, but I kind of love it. It's sort of like smaller pixels almost. We got some pine trees going up. Very, very nice indeed. We've got a little campfire over here. This is looking very cool. And the river's slightly changed, but it's like freezing over in some points. It looks like, I like that. That looks really cool. We got the pine tree as well. And oh my gosh, look at the house. It's so cute. Oh, I love this use of like, you know, the chickens. What animals she used, I don't know. But, you know, the leaves, I think that's a really cool thing to do. And the house itself, oh my gosh, it's kind of like Nordic in a way. It's really cool. I love the style. And that roof with the snow, wow. Okay, that's, I've never seen the snow used like that before. That looks awesome. I've seen people do it with like slabs and stuff, you know, to make the curved roofs, but never with snow. That's so cool. And the house itself is adorable. I love it. And the bushes and stuff. Really, really cool. Let's have a look inside, shall we? Okay, so we've got our crafting area over here. Wow, this is looking awesome. Little clock on the wall. We've got some vines hanging down from the ceiling. I like the use of like the trap doors there for the curved. We've got our furnaces and some barrels, etc. storage. We've got like a nice little seating area over here with a piston. Oh, I love this sort of like cupboard design here. That is really cute. And we've got a little desk as well. Wow, this is really nice. And the bedroom here as well. Very, very cute. I love this. This is awesome. It's crazy. We've had 5 builds and it's all started from the same house and they're all so different. And I love it. I love all of them. And just to remind you, this is what the original house looked like. Yeah. Everyone's done such a good job. I want to say thank you to Scott, Fwip, Shubble, Catherine, and Pearlescent Moon for taking part in this. This is so nice of you to do for me. They obviously spent a lot of time on this, so thank you to them. And you should definitely go check out their channels. The links will be in the description. Please go subscribe to them. They are all great YouTubers. This video isn't a competition. None of them did it better than the other. I think they all did it in their own way, and that was what this whole video is about. I really, really enjoyed this, and I hope you guys did too. So thank you so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe if you're new, and more importantly, subscribe to everyone else. Leave a like and comment, and I shall see you another time. Goodbye.